Right now, we are going to meet scientists who want to build a more sustainable world with wood as the raw material. Materials for packaging that won't wear out the Earth's resources, but instead are completely biodegradable. Thread made from wood stronger than carbon fiber, and fabric to make intelligent garments.
So this long-term effort that Wallenberg Wood Science Center is has allowed us to develop a deep molecular understanding of wood. And with this understanding, we can now bring together completely new materials that can enable a more sustainable world.
Out from our great forests come the raw materials that will replace plastics and build something entirely new. They are looking to use all of the components of the tree. Here at the Wallenberg Wood Science Center at KTH in Stockholm, the wood is broken up. Wood chips become cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin.
With this molecular understanding, we can actually bring together completely new materials with completely unknown properties. So for instance, if we take this nanoscopic cellulose and bring it together in a particular way, we can make solid water, which can be used for medical applications, for instance. If we take other wood-based components, we can actually replace fossil-based wood adhesives, completely circumventing the use of formaldehyde, which is a great development. If we take the nanostructured part of cellulose and bring it together in a clever way, we can make the world's strongest biofiber. Then we can replace carbon fiber or glass fiber with wood-based fiber.
And it doesn't stop there. When the scientists remove the lignin that gives the wood its brown color, they can fill the empty spaces with transparent plant material and create a transparent wood that can be used as glass. And if, for example, the cars of the future are made from pine, and the windows of the future are made from spruce, even the technology inside may be made from wood.
What we are trying to do now is to use the living plant and the chemistry of the living plant to give extra functionality into the wood. And this is something that we have initial results that is working, so we can have a conducting wood that is developing within the growing tree. Then we can harvest and use in different devices.
But the trees should also be able to store energy, electrical energy. Here, the roots are charged with sunlight, and electricity is then released when a button is pressed, causing the display to light up.
Think of having trees acting like batteries. Our biggest aim is how to use biological components in technological systems in order to give technology some of these living characteristics. Being able to harness some of these processes can open new possibilities of what we can have, like a new type of technology that we cannot even maybe imagine today.
Ideas are growing out of the forests. The researchers are hoping that the new will replace the old everywhere. and that we will eventually even wear materials from trees.
An electronic textile is very similar to the textiles that you and me wear, but they are textiles where we have added an additional functionality. This can, for example, be an electrically conducting fiber that we have integrated into the textile.
And the fabric of the future may be woven from threads made from the cellulose of trees. Then the researchers dye the threads with an electrically conductive material.
In the future, we will be able to interact with our environment in very different ways. We will be able to sense what is going on around us. Textiles will be able to tell something about us and send information out there. And in order to enable that communication, to also power this myriad of devices that are surrounding us, there we're going to use electronic textiles.
A synergy between new technology and the age-old trees is coming closer day by day as knowledge increases.
We generate new ideas in the center, create great new thoughts, hopefully inspire others. But what really makes the difference is the students that we train, that go out there and really take these ideas and the know-how that they have acquired while working in the center with others. They then either go to companies and implement that, or they actually found their own companies. And that's what really makes the difference.
Absolutely. The opportunity these PhD students have had within WWSC has really brought them a lot of expertise knowledge that they can convey to the industry and also make the industry more prepared to actually accelerate the new research findings into new products that fulfills the need of tomorrow's materials.